Is everything good? I got no boogers in my nose. I'm all good. All right. Hey, good morning, my friends and family. And that's as much enthusiasm you're gonna get from me, because I am tired. Let me tell you something. I'm tired. All right. But I'll tell you what. I'm not tired on Source of Adventures. So today is like day two at Unsk-Komegorsk. I'm surprised I can still say the name pretty right. I probably would have forgotten by now, but the city is getting a hold of me. The people are nice. The trolleys are nice. The buses are nice. This place has more color than me, so that's nice. And we're gonna try to see. We got Avocado, my Yandex driver slash translator slash now she's my PR manager, because I was a celebrity yesterday. Let me tell you what. When people find out you're American, oh, I'm still not kidnapped yet, so that's good. Everyone was like going crazy, like, this is a real life American guy? Is this real? Oh, no way. Like, no, he's fake. He's a hologram. Yeah, but last night, there was a lot of people who were just like, oh man, there's no way this is an American guy. Why is an American guy in Kazakhstan? So, I'm telling you.
Hey,
gosh, you're ruining the video quality. She doesn't want to be inside the videos, but yeah, she wants to talk. I can't put avocados all over her voice. What do avocados sound like? See? But anyways, I'll let you guys know what this next source of adventure is before I head back to Astana. So, I'll turn the camera on when there's something interesting. Alright, bye bye. Everything I know will be gone in a minute. And that's alright. Alright, cause I'm free. I don't even feel like I'm in Kazakhstan anymore. Friends, as you can tell, this city is actually very beautiful.
Look, so
it's a very beautiful city.
Любовь навсегда.
It's hard to know that this city was affected by the Polygon and the nuclear test sites. This is a very beautiful city, and I don't even feel like I'm in Kazakhstan anymore. Kazakhstan is such a diverse, like, biodiversity here. It's just amazing. But, who killed him? Who killed this bird?
Nobody,
he
just changed.
No, he did not. Birds did not just change their feathers. Someone murdered that bird. And that is the 10th, that's number 10 right there. That's 10 dead birds I've seen.
Very fast
river.
Yeah. Very deep, like a mountain river.
Mm.
Нормально же разговариваете?
пойдем. Конкретно тут он шпарит, здесь опасно купаться, то есть, потому что так, вот здесь идут шлюзы, чтобы можно было проехать, ну, на катере. То есть вот здесь шлюза, шлюзование.
The bolts are for here?
Чтобы можно было туда-сюда проехать.
So, this is like the, I'll tell you guys when we get a better vantage points so we can see it. But this is very unexpected. We really got the jackpot on this one. our driver is very knowledgeable. He's been living here for 47 years in Unskomagorsk. And is actually his son, I was telling you, lives in America, is going to Oklahoma University, or one of those Oklahoma schools. Well, he knows a lot about his own city, which is good because there's a lot of stuff that I was learning about Unskomagorsk, about the polygon, about Simi, and just very interested in seeing. These are the two biggest cities on East Kazakhstan, and it's one thing to read articles, stuff on the internet, read books, but it's another thing to actually go and see what's actually going on there. So, unlike some people who don't want to go visit the US-Mexico border, but it's really important to see, like, get your eyes on what's going on, because you get to learn more. And then you meet local people who tell you about everything about the city. And so, Unskomagorsk. There's a lot of information to tell you, but here we got a better vantage point. Soviet, very Soviet Union stuff.
Полностью. Like a person. Prison, да?
Prison, да. Very Soviet style. Hopefully it doesn't break. I mean, it's been surviving for so long. But this is Ishik River.
Hey.
Irtysh River. Wow, this has got to be deep. I can already tell how deep it is. Scary.
Especially because you're scared on the high.
Oh gosh. All right, so I need to get his name. The driver, I didn't even get his name. He went straight into the conversation. He's a pretty cool guy. What he was telling us is that during the Soviet Union, Unskomagorsk was on the list of cities to destroy once it broke away from the Soviet Union, because the city is rich and all kind of rare earth minerals, so like titanium, plutonium, all these other things. And so Soviet Union lost access to that. Not really, they made a deal with the Kazakhstan to keep having that access to it, of course, but this was on the first of the list to destroy it, is what he was telling me. Another thing is like the polygon did play a huge effect, but it's not just the polygon that played an effect here in the city. It's also, there's about 3,000 factories that surround this city, and like I said, they're very rich in rare earth minerals, and they don't even tell the people what kind of radioactive material they bring into the city. And so, like we're talking about with that one river that's buried underneath the city because it's radioactive. And for the most part though, most of the city is not radioactive. They already identified like the special places where it's like super high in radioactivity. But he's just showing me, this is supposed to be the world's tallest boat lift, which is here. And this is really deep lake. very deep, like one of the deepest lakes, I guess, here in Kazakhstan. So divide, divide. I'm about to leave the village of Privolonyo. Privolonyo. Probably said that wrong. Pretty bad. Just want to take a quick stop over here. About an hour and a half outside Unskomergorsk. Look at this view. Look at this view. Ain't nothing out here except the mosque and the gas station.